Comedy Workshops Live Slate.
All cameras got that. Okay, now, do not ever turn off the camera. Good luck, God bless, enjoy the show. Start.
Good evening, and welcome to Comedy Workshop Live. I am Rip Hostile, Esquire, the show's official legal advisor. For the records, my reading of the following legal disclaimer is being videotaped on Wednesday, November 19th, 2014, at 7:36 p.m. The recording will serve as evidence that you, the audience, have in fact heard disclaimer and offered no objections whatsoever. Nothing that you will hear or see in the show is true. If you try to initiate legal action against Comedy Workshop Live, you will not win, but you will show everyone that you are a frigid fool with no sense of humor. By remaining in your seat, you are giving us permission to videotape you and use the footage in any way we choose, including but not limited to photoshopping, YouTubing, Facebooking, texting, and sexting. If you do not smile at least once during the show, you will be given promotional tickets to our February episode, filmed in the Russian town of Donetsk in the Ukraine. If you did not get this joke, please place $20 in the jar. Thank you, sir. We admire your character. Quiet. Finally, if at any moment during the show you are trying to choose between getting offended and laughing, always choose the latter. And now, without further ado, please welcome the host of Comedy Workshop Live, Mr. Zhenya Kipperman.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Counselor, for this entertaining legal disclaimer. It set great tone for the show. Good evening, and welcome to Comedy Workshop.
You're welcome. I just want to remind you that it took me 3 hours to write that disclaimer, and okay. my rate is $350 per hour.
No worries. As soon as we get some real money into the jar, the first thing we do is compensating you at exactly the rate you now mentioned, at $3.50 per hour. Good evening, and welcome.
No, the rate is $300.
If you don't shut up, we don't pay you nothing. Good evening, and welcome to Comedy Workshop Live. As our wonderful legal advisor, Mr. Rip Hostel, just mentioned in his legal disclaimer.
It's Hostile.
Man, I'm trying to start the show, man.
Huh? The name is pronounced Hostile.
No, it's Hostile. I know English. It's H-O-S-T-I-L-E. It's Hostile or Hostile?
Hostile.
Okay, what about your first name?
My first name is Rip.
Rip, as in rip off?
No, as in Ripley.
No, $3.50 per hour is a rip off. Anyway, as the rip-off Hostile just mentioned in his legal disclaimer, we're videotaping the show. We have no intention to do texting or sexting or alternating your image in any way. But you may end up on tape and in our broadcast version. So by remaining in your seats, you do give us permission to videotape you, okay? Now I'd like to introduce our band. You've heard the band already. The band is called Groove Merchants. Thank you. Thank you very much. Now, I'm a foreigner, so I don't really know what groove merchants means, so I'll just introduce them one by one, starting with the bass player, Mr. John Evan Groom III. Thank you. Let's hear for the drum player, Mr. Anthony Guidotti. And on the guitar, Mr. Luke Ferracone. All these Italians on the band. I feel like introducing the band from Godfather. This was fast, huh? Good musicians. Reaction like as if they're comedians. The last but not least, the singer and the guitar player, Mr. Ty Vallone. Yeah, he's a man of many talents. And he's the only one on the band who got a mic, and he got a mic not because he's singing, but because he's laughing. We noticed he has sense of humor, the only one on the band, so we gave him the mic. Performers, thank you for being part of the show. Three things. One, be brave. Two, enjoy yourselves. Three, stay tasteful. Because it's a college environment, right? And we even have some professors here, believe it or not. By staying tasteful, I don't necessarily mean do not curse. Louis C.K. manages to curse and stay tasteful most of the time. So if you feel that curse word is an essential part of your comedy act, go for it. Worst comes to worst, we may cut it out of the broadcast version, or we may beep it out. Beep it out so your comedy act in the broadcast version may sound something like that. Yesterday, this guy rear-ended me. I stop at the intersection. Suddenly, bam, this guy going 45, hits me in the back. I get out of the car. I approach him. I go, are you beeping blind? The guy gets out of the car. Huge mother beeper. He goes, who the beep do you think you're beeping with your beep? I will beep you up and beep your mother. And then my mother gets out of the car, and she's a little woman, 75 years old, and she goes, thank you, sir. See, I still got some laughs, even though all the brilliance, comedic brilliance, was beeped out. All right? Anyway, I am now excited to introduce our first performer, the man who had guts to audition the first for the show. I figured he'll have guts to open it. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Mr. Andrew Schroeder.
Hello. Thank you. Thank you, everybody. Thank you very much. My name is Andrew, and a lot of people, it doesn't take very long for them to know something about me. It's that I'm pretty bad with girls. And thank you. And one reason people pick up on this pretty quickly is because I'm the kind of guy, I'll pick up a microphone, get on stage, and announce it to a room. But, you know, one story that comes to mind is I'm in local Rite Aid, 16 years old, because I got to buy morning after pill. You know, that's a little traumatizing for me. I come from a small town. Everybody knows each other. You know, I know the old lady behind the counter at the Rite Aid and everything. And, I mean, it's awkward for me to buy condoms, obviously. So, so I go up to the lady, you know, my girlfriend, she's really nervous. I said, you know, don't worry, I'm gonna go and take care of it, gonna be the man. So I walk in, I said to the, you know, pharmacist, I need the morning after pill. Very disappointed in me, you know. She says, I'm sorry, you know, you need to be 18. And the girl needs to be here because it's for her. That's Pennsylvania state law. Okay. Thank you, Pennsylvania State. So I go back to the car, and she's nervous, just as they're nervous and everything. And I said, you know, I got good news and bad news. The bad news is, you know, you're still pregnant, and I didn't get the medicine and everything, you know. But the good news is we still have a huge window for this first trimester. So now, I know New York is probably a little more liberal than Pennsylvania, so I give them a quick call. I don't live far from the border, and I said, you know, can I get the morning after pill? Blah, 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 blah. I said, not a problem, come on over. So we go over to Port Jervis, New York, scary little town in New York, and I go in, and, you know, just waiting in the car, and I said, you know, I'm here for the morning after pill. They said, oh, yeah, that's right, you were on the phone. And I said, yes, that was me. And they said, well, we're sold out. I said, thank you very much for telling me this. It's a 10 a.m. on a Wednesday. This town is awful. So, now we cross the border. We're in Montague, New Jersey, in a ShopRite in Montague, New Jersey, with a little pharmacy and everything. And I'm exhausted at this point. You know, this was supposed to be a fun little adventure for the day. And now, you know, this is, it's almost seems easier if we just, you know what, let's just have the kid. So, I go in. I go to the lady, I go to the pharmacist, I said, you know, I'm not 18. My girlfriend isn't here, she's not 18. I have $40, can I please, please, please get the morning after pill? The lady says, not a problem. She goes, gets the medicine, gets it to me, and I hand her the money, and I'm so relieved at this point. I've been waiting all day for this, and I grab it from her and I said, thank you so much. You are a real lifesaver. And I looked at it and I thought, well, I guess not, huh? Thank you, guys.
Andrew confessed to me before the show that this story actually in real life has a happier ending. Turns out that the pharmacist, instead of giving him morning after pill, just gave him vitamin B12 that looks exactly the same. Child is 11 months old, name is Rachel, lives with her grandparents in Minnesota. Sorry, I had to tell them, because for cheap laughs, I just had to reveal this.
Yeah. You know, I'm hoping, I'm looking around with the budget and everything, I'm hoping no one sees this, so that way, because, you know, that's a private story, Zhenya.
Okay, all right. What's your major?
My major is history.
History. Where can we see you perform?
You can see me perform next December 5th on campus at the IFC Jingle Ball Testicle Festival.
Testicles. Check out. Taking notes, testicles, he'll be performing it for the testicles. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear again for Andrew Schroeder. Thank you very much. Thank you. Our next act came with Andrew, and he's a good friend of Andrew, and he was the... What? What was that? Very nice. You want to perform? Come. Oh, I know. Don't worry. We have a skit for you. Just wait. Just wait and get ready. You look right. I'm excited to invite to the stage our first guest star. Please welcome Mr. Andrew Malafarina. And one important thing about Andrew, he's our alum. Not only he's alum of Kutztown University, he's alum of Electronic Media Program, okay? Our own. So now you will see what we taught him.
Yeah. I used to go here. I graduated about 2 years ago. It was in electronic media for about 4 years. And then, yeah, like I said, I graduated. So now I work in a kitchen. Because that's what happens. You go to school and then you relax and then life crushes you. Yeah. I work in a kitchen and it's a... Oh, what's that word? Oh, yeah, the worst. I work at a place called Boston's Gourmet Pizza. Because you know how they're known for that. Yeah, might see if Seattle Cheesesteaks has any openings. That doesn't work. Let's call up Florida Bagels. Because all those are real things. 90% of the people that work there are fantastic because they don't piss test. So every day turns into one of those choose your own adventure books. You gotta pick out which drug you want. It's like, ooh, it's Marijuana Mondays. Let's go to the dishwasher, figure out which Fish album's the best. He says Farmhouse. I disagree. I don't know if you heard, but I have a, I like to call it a goofy last name. It's just absurd. My last name is Malafarina. It's like, and I don't, like, people say it wrong all the time because it's just long and too many letters. And I don't get upset about that. I understand. It's a bad name. Don't say it right. But other people get real particular, like, hey, man, my forefathers killed some people in the 1800s, so say it right. I was just like, no, don't worry about mine. My last name's Malfrina. It's Italian for bad wheat. I'm not going to go figure out what my family seal is. It's probably just some sad farmer holding a dead bale of hay. Just shrugging like someone with a better last name could have done something with this. I have really bad anxiety all the time, and that usually comes from expectations. Like, you know, having them, or also people having them about me. I don't know if you saw me and you're just like, oh, he's got dirty shoes and a flannel. Maybe he knows how to forage. Nope, not at all. Not at all. I can teach you how to download the Parent Trap illegally. I was doing a show the other night and I did my set, I go outside. This girl who was in the show, she walks out and her friend is about to walk in. And her friend asks her, she's like, how's the show inside? Is it good? Should I go in? She's like, it's okay. You know, there was this chubby redheaded guy up and he was fine, but he was no George Carlin or nothing. And for if you don't get the reference, George Carlin, he was a man who did this and he was the best at it. And I'm just trying to make it work at a college in Pennsylvania. And like going out with expectations like that, that's like if you watched a whole season of Hell's Kitchen and then just went to Applebee's and was like, what is this? Gordon Ramsay said nothing about any tizers. Gonna order a parfait while I look at this picture of dogs playing cards. All right, guys, thank you. I'm Andy Malfrini. Have a great night.
Thank you very much. Now, seriously, did we help you any with the our major?
Absolutely did. It's just a joke. I work in a kitchen because I'm lazy. If you try hard, Kutztown equips you.
Can't be lazy because we didn't accept any lazy students in the electronic media ever.
I wasn't lazy in school. Afterwards, just went downhill.
Okay. All right. Where can we see you perform?
November 29th, I'll be in Bethlehem at the Steel Stacks doing 2 laugh minimum, 8 p.m.
2 laugh minimum and 2 drinks minimum. You know how it works.
Yes.
Right?
Sure.
2 drinks minimum, and then you drive home, and the cop stops you, and he gets 2 tickets minimum. They all work together. All right, Andrew Malafarina. Thank you very much. I want to thank Eckhouse of Kutztown, our partner on the project. This is an art gallery on Main Street, like right across from Tammy's sushi place. There's Tammy's sushi place, and across from it, there's Eckhouse Gallery. The address is 157 West Main Street. And it's an art gallery that has all kinds of artistic events. On Thursdays, they have open mic Thursday nights, 7 to 9 p.m. And anybody can come and recite poetry or do stand-up comedy or sing a song, anything. And there, at Eckhouse on these Thursday nights, we cast maybe 80% of our show, thanks to Eckhouse. And I want to thank them. I want to thank their very capable and lovely directors, Bree and Danny. They probably didn't make it, but they will see this on television one day. Our next performer, as I said, was discovered in Eckhouse. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm very excited to invite to the stage our only female songwriter. Please welcome Leah Manetti. Rob will come back with his own act, and let's hear again for Rob, who, by the way, Rob came for the first time to Eckhouse on the same night they met, late September. Now it feels like they're playing together for 5 years or 10 years, but they just met less than 2 months ago. Leah, just 2 questions, relax, they're very easy questions, easy questions. First question, what's your major?
Fine arts.
Fine arts. Oh, very good. The last time the rehearsal was a different major. You should switch quickly. Second question. Where and when can we hear you perform?
Every Thursday night at Eckhouse.
Leah Manetti. I'd like to thank our audio team sitting right there. And I want to ask Matt Peterson to get a nice shot of them. And the shot better be in focus. Yeah, because this is the most challenging job on the show. Jake, thank you very much. Jake Wager. And Kyle Krell. And Chris Latrell. And Nick D'Amico, who just joined them today, who is our alum and who is great. So thank you, guys. Thank you very much. Please welcome Mr. Derek Free.
My name is Derek Free, and I'm going to perform two poems for you tonight as a pair, one right after the other. And the first one is called A Letter from My Feet to My Work Boots. Dear Work Boots, when we first met, I was blown away by your rigid form. You stood with presence. You had attitude. No one could walk over you, but I didn't know how to treat you right. I was used to flimsier models. As we spent more time together and my calluses healed, I learned how you needed to be worn. I had to slow my pace with you, one step at a time. As you adjusted to my unusual stride, I learned to walk with grace. We fit into each other now. Our rhythm is the same. The way your laces tighten around me, you assure me your comfort won't just slip away. The warmth you bring to my soles is one I desire to step into every day. You feel you have a void that must be filled, but I am here to tell you, you are perfect. Any day you wish to share with me, I will walk with you to any destination. Love, Feet. And the next poem I'd like to perform is called I Miss. I miss getting so drenched running in the rain, I would run through every puddle. I miss mentally escaping on my bicycle. I miss pouring all of my Legos on the carpet just to see that they were all there. I miss doing push-ups to deal with my stepdad. I miss when the only thing I used to cry at was Biggest Loser. I miss being kicked out of the kiddie pool. I miss when all of my friends were only a bike ride away instead of a click away. I miss turning down pickup games to talk about girls during sixth grade recess. I miss making artwork when the act of doing it was the only thing I cared about. I miss apple butter served in mason jars. I miss dreaming about superheroes from the moment I woke up to the moment I fell asleep. I miss grocery shopping with her.
Uh, I want to say, I don't know about you, but I was impressed by the character transition from the first to second poem. You know, showed a great acting range on the part of Derek and a great lighting job of our lighting team by Josh Manson and Nate Colasimo, who are over there in the booth. So, and let's hear for all three of them, Derek and the lighting team. Thank you, guys. Great job. Inspired choice.
Yeah, now, yes, the lighting was good. The poems were good, but this was not funny.
I'm glad you enjoyed the performance.
Okay, well, yeah, first of all, the first poem was funny. You just don't have sense of humor, but that's okay because lawyers don't need it. I do have a couple more questions for Derek. Your last name spells F-R-E-E-H.
Yes.
The pronunciation is free.
Mm-hmm.
Would you drop the H?
I feel like I'm basically holding on to it as like history. I mean, basically, I'm very German. And so the actual
You're
name
very
is,
German.
I'm
what
very
does
German.
That mean?
Well, I'm going to tell you in a second. my name, in it's actually spelled F-R-U-Umlau-E-H. So it really performed Frua. But, you know, from Ellis Island and people pronouncing things, they dropped that and now it's free.
Yes.
Complicated.
Yes. And I'm a Jew and I love Umlaut from H3. This joke will not make it into the broadcast version, so don't worry. All right, another question. Actually, question for the audience, okay? If you are, especially ladies, possibly gentlemen too, if you are to choose between a poet and a lawyer for a boyfriend, who would you choose? Huh?
Poet,
very nice, poet, there, we get, yeah, that's a good answer, yeah, because yeah, I've gone out with some lawyers and some poets, and I would, you know, my word of wisdom, always choose the poet. If he's mentally
this
stable.
This is not funny.
Anyway, this one is called Derek Free. This one is called as Rip Off Hostel. Who would you pick?
Hostel.
Yeah, see what I mean? Anyway, so there is a no-brainer. For a boyfriend, we all would pick this one. But when the time comes to get married, it's a different question, a tougher one. Okay, tell us honestly, ladies, when the time comes to get married, who would you pick then?
Lawyer.
Huh?
They didn't even hesitate. Hello,
see, that's the truth. We appreciate the honesty, very nice. What's your name?
Carly
Hastil. Get her number after the show, she, you know. Anyway, I think, I offer two scenarios, okay? When the time comes to get married, Derek learns how to make money, and then you can choose him again as a husband, okay? That's scenario number one. However, with his major in fine arts, it's unlikely. So then, scenario number two, by the time comes to get married, he's still not making any money, he's just reciting his poetry with passion on stage, okay? Still living in this basement studio with no windows. And then you choose as a husband, Mr. Hastil, and keep Derek as a lover. So it's a win-win for Derek anyway. Thank you, Derek. So keep reciting poetry, you'll be fine anyhow.
Will do.
Derek Free, thank you very much. Our out-of-state guest and the youngest performer on the program, let's welcome Miss Naomi Benenson.
Thank you.
Naomi, you are at the age when asking you about your age is still not rude. Can we ask you about your age?
Go ahead.
Okay, how old are you, Naomi?
I just turned 14.
Just turned 14, okay? 14. Okay. So do you want to be a dancer?
I want to be an entrepreneur.
Who?
An entrepreneur.
Castile, do you know the word she just used?
You don't?
Never mind. Do you know the word? What is it? Explain quickly to the people.
She wants to start a business.
Oh, okay. Thank you very much. See, lawyers sometimes of use. Okay, so you have a project in mind. What is it?
Yeah, I'm actually developing an app where it will give, called Wish to Wish.
Oh, you develop whom?
I'm developing an app.
App? Do you know what
yeah.
app is? App? Is it app?
Application.
Thank you. Who said that? Check out big brain on this guy. Anyway.
Yeah, I'm developing an app called Wish to Wish where it will give a home to your dreams and wishes, and you'll be able to explore and interact with wishes near and far. And I have a website called wishtowish.com. So it's wish and then the number
wish2. Wishtowish.com. Are you taking notes?
Yeah, wishtowish2.com.
Of this sequence, I know what that means.
That's good. That's step one. Right.
And what's your website? You have a website? That's your website?
That is my website. Wishtowish.com.
Wishtowish.com is your website.
Correct.
Anyway, Naomi Benenson.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. The time has come, ladies and gentlemen, for your active and brave participation. We're about to perform a skit that we called Street Smart Manual. We need a guy to volunteer for the thing.
Steven.
Oh, Steve, come. Very nice. Very nice. Yeah, you don't have to strip, you can come dressed. But quickly, Steve, quick. All right. So you are, you know what? You're good, but you will not face the audience. Yeah, I see. Yeah, I appreciate that. This is all right. We'll be nice to you now. Okay, now you go. You will be the bully. You will not be the music lover. You will be the bully, the dangerous guy. Okay, because we can't cast you as a wimp. It will be miscasting. You know, you don't look like a wimp to me. So go there behind. What's your name?
Sam.
Behind Sam. And just wait for us. Now we need a wimp.
Pockets!
Yeah.
Pockets!
All right, come. Hayden, come. Yeah, Hayden. Yeah, here comes our. Yeah, very good. Yes, quickly, but quickly. Yeah, very good. Okay, nice. Now, Hayden. This is Hayden. Now you'll play a wimp on the show, and one day you may even get some gross or net profits on the show. Go stand over there. All the way in the corner, but still remaining in the light. Go, keep going. Stop. Is he still in the light?
Yes. Yes.
All right, very good. Okay, now. So you just walked out of Carnegie Hall. You just heard your favorite symphony by Beethoven, right? And you just experienced catharsis. Do you know catharsis?
I do.
What is catharsis?
A release.
All right, catharsis is a release. Well, in a way, yes. Okay, so he just experienced this kind of release, catharsis, from music, and he walks to his car, and on his way, he is passed by this guy. It's a 57th Street, you know, Carnegie Hall. Now, you just behave the way you would behave in real life. That's all, okay? And I'll just tell him what to do. He goes, intentionally? Yes, intentionally. Now, music, please. Street Smart Manual, real street smart situation. And action. And cut. What was that? I didn't ask you to push him all the way like 15 meters back to Carnegie Hall, man. All I asked to body check. Come, I show you body check. Body check is this. Come. So all you do is, you're a little tall for me, but anyway, body check is just this. That's all we need, okay? What you did was this. You just relax. What you did was this. That's what you did. It wasn't body check. All right, anyway, quickly, quickly. It takes time. Quickly, do the normal body check and you react to it like you would in real life. You can't ignore it in real life. If you can ignore that, then you got the problem. All right, and music, please. Action. What was that? You said you were sorry? Okay, very nice. Well, that was authentic, because that's what a wimp would do. He would say I am sorry, and then the rest is peaceful. Just the bully just walks away feeling satisfied, because this guy just said I'm sorry. Okay, that's plausible. Very good. I'm serious. What you did was fine, but what if you are with a girl? Go back in position quickly. Go. Now, our lady, please come. You are his girlfriend. You are his girlfriend. You together went to the Beethoven Symphony. Together experienced release, like he said. And now you just...
He's like, what?
Now you just
right
walked out. You just walked out. What? All right. Anyway, now you're just walking to your car together, and this thing happens. Now let's see what happens with the girl, because with a girl saying, I am sorry to this guy in this situation is kind of embarrassing. So hopefully there is something else happening, right? Something else is about to happen, and music, please.
Hold hands.
Action.
Grab that hand. Hold hands.
He said sorry again. Now, question to the audience. What is the fastest, most effective way to put the bully out of commission quickly?
Hit Alton.
What? What? Where? Balls. Who said that? Balls. To kick him in the balls. That's what we'll do. All right. Yeah. So, honey, what's your name again?
Sam.
Yeah, Sam. You have to kick him in the balls.
She can't kick him in the balls.
Of course you can. You were talking loudly through
no.
my opening. You're very brave. You can do it. No, you were. That's the price you pay, honey, for ruining our funny show. You kick him in the balls. It's easy to do. What was that?
If she kicks him in the balls, yeah. He will sue her and you and the show.
She will sue? Really? He will sue.
Yes, I have a lot of lawyers in my family.
Are you kidding me? We're struggling here. You know how hard it is for with no money putting together exciting show. It's a very funny bit. He just kicks you in the balls and you just pretend it's funny. Come on, do it for us.
I want to, you know, I want the Majiri name to carry on in the future. So I don't know if, you know, kicking me in the balls.
Okay. Are you saying the balls have something to do with that?
Somewhat.
Okay, well, maybe, I don't know. Not in Russia, but maybe here. Okay. All right, well, then you know what? We will just pretend. We'll just pretend. It will be a stunt. I teach you, what's your name again?
Sam.
Okay, it's still Sam. Okay. Now, I will teach you what to do. You just copy me. Very simple, very simple. Just watch me. You just do this. After he body checks him, and he again says, I'm sorry. He says, I'm sorry again. That's what you do, you sucker. Okay. So, and then at this moment, you suddenly, unexpectedly, you do this. You do this. Bam! All right? How was that?
You grazed him.
I did what?
You grazed them.
I grazed them?
Grazed.
Grazed. I don't know. I will look up the verb, but it was flattering. Thank you. All right, anyway, so can you do that? Try, don't worry, and just graze them, just graze them slightly, and he will appreciate even more from a lady, okay? All right, in positions, quickly, music, please, music starts, and action. What was that? What was that reaction? Have you ever been kicked in the balls?
She missed.
She missed.
Now, She does that, you drop like it's painful, and then that's the end. If you don't, then the third take, she does kick you. That's the deal. Go back in position. Quickly, quickly. And music, please. And action. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Because our love is just smoke.